Hi. Next we will look into Cubase and how it is configured for MIDI in and out for external instruments and controllers. And in Cubase, I think it has actually the most extensive MIDI environment in the sense that you also can configure the layout of your external controllers and see them in Cubase and then map them to different actions or things within Cubase. So I will not go to that extent, but I will just briefly show how to do things in Cubase. So let's get going. Okay, let's start Cubase and see how the MIDI is configured in Cubase. Let's open an empty project just to have it around, and first we need to go to Studio and Studio Setup. So in Cubase we already looked on audio system and audio configuration, and now we will dive into MIDI and MIDI remote settings. So first let's look on the MIDI ports. Here you have actually all the MIDI ports listed, which are coming in and are going out. Also you are able to configure the visibility of these when selecting these channels, like MIDI in and MIDI out. Let's only have those ports visible that are meaningful from the MIDI in point of view, like Lumi key, MIDI clock, then Stream Deck, Machina, I use that to control. Then I have the meta system also configured with my Cubase. So if I go and look on the iPad, you can see that now in the meta grid, you can control Cubase through the iPad interface. Anyway, let's get back to MIDI configuration. So all these are relevant, although I don't need the Ableton Live port. I only need the Cubase. I don't need the Logic. And that I need. And I don't need Studio One. Most likely I will use Metasystem MCU. Then also I use Monochrome Monitor. Then for the SSL UF8, I need to have, of course, the port selected through which I control my mixer through SSL UF8. And if I would use V-Control in a sense, then I would need to have those enabled. But I don't use V-Control with Cubase, so I can take those away. I do want to have the Vienna instrument in it. But then again, I don't need any of these Mio XL ports that are coming from the network or from the synthesizers. I don't want them to be visible, but I also don't want them to be active. So I'll just basically unactivate all of them because I don't need them. And as I'm only sending MIDI out to those devices and I'm not recording MIDI in from any of those. So now I have only selected the ones that I want to use and have active. Let's see. Yeah, I don't need this active either. Yeah, I don't need to have this in all MIDI in. And let's see, I don't need these either in all MIDI in, so I'll just take them away. I want to have them active and visible, but I don't want them to be included into all MIDI in, so not this one, not neither. Maybe I'll just leave those around, and I'll also remove these. So when we go and see how to basically have the MIDI in routing into a track, we can then see that there is only the ones that I have selected here are visible, and the only those I can select. So it will clean up my system a bit regarding on selecting MIDI channels that are coming in. Similarly, MIDI going out, I don't need to send MIDI out and I don't want those to be visible. Also, Lumi, I don't need that to be visible. Neither Ableton push. MIDI clock, maybe. I don't need these either. Machine, maybe. And then I don't need... Okay, let's cancel that. Let's have that then. Because it... No. And let's have that also. And then... let's take the others. Okay, no. Let's have a monogram of... okay, it needs to go out. That's for sure. So, yeah, the ones that I have, Cubase out and MIDI and also monogram module, I need to have visual. Okay, so yeah. So that visibility also most likely then means active. Anyway, here I have TR8S is selected. And then I don't need these V controls. I don't need V pan. I don't need that one either. And I don't need any of these network or actually USB connections to be available. But I do want to have my JD990. This is actually wrong, as I don't have a JB880 anymore. And that I don't need. And I actually need to add a few new things. So, for example, I need to power my Oberheim OBX8 in order to have it visual over here. So I'll do that. Same I will do for the Juno X and configure it also correctly in Cubase. Okay, let's go. Okay, now we can see that the list changed and. Let's go up here and see where do we have the new added synthesizers. So we do have OBX8 here and it's active, so it's correct. And then let's see that we have the Juno X also came somewhere here. There it is. Yeah. And at this time I don't need the door control. I just send MIDI to Juno X. So now everything is set up when it comes to MIDI ports and the visibility. Then we can take a second look on the remote controls of MIDI. So MIDI remote. These are the things that you can actually create in Cubase. And that's actually handy that you can visually see and create a layout for your controllers. Like in this case, I have created a visual representation of my monogram module. And you can see that everything works there correctly. So everything is mapped nice and nicely. And from here, you can actually add new controllers and map them and also do mapping for these in Cubase so that these buttons and sliders will control certain things in Cubase. And that's quite handy. When it comes to remote devices, here is an example of configuring a MIDI controller into Cubase. So I have added this meta system into my system and I have three different profiles for it. Then as a Mackie controller, I have the SSL UF8 so that I can control the mixer and all other different type of functionality. I actually don't have any Mackie HUI, so I could basically... I should actually be able to trash that because it's maybe there by mistake or example. And then I have these quick track controls that I could configure, but it's a legacy stuff, and VST quick control as well. So anyway, I have these two main controllers that I'm using to control the transport and MIDI control things regarding on mixing and the mixer. So that's pretty much it from the MIDI configuration over here. Let's look then how the MIDI is used when dealing with external instruments or dealing with internal instruments. Let's start with the external ones so we can then play around a bit with MIDI and going in and out. So I'll create a MIDI track and let's say that this is OBX8. And only one at this time. Now basically I can here see that all MIDI input is coming into this track. Of course I could then only select the one that I want to get MIDI in. For example, like from a Lumi keyboard. And then I can select here that where do I actually send my MIDI out. And in this case, you know, I would send it, of course, into OBX. So now the MIDI goes into OBX. But then I also need to select the channel from here so that it's a correct channel. And if I remember correctly, it was channel 10. Yeah, so now you can see that MIDI is going out, but nothing is coming in for the reason that there is no audio channel that is routed in. So I'll add an audio track, a stereo one, and then I go and select the OBX8. And let's name that as OBX8 old audio. And let's put it into the monitoring mode. And if we go here and play something, we can basically then hear that everything works now nicely. And I can only get MIDI controlling from the Lumi keys, but then of course I could here have the all MIDI inputs. And now I could use any of my MIDI keyboard to get MIDI messages in. But that's pretty much it from the MIDI instruments point of view. And then of course the controllers work as well, as you can see that when I press from my press play from my Metagrid, the Cubase starts to play. So with the Metagrid I can control the Cubase, and now you can actually see that things actually change here as well when I do things, and as you can see it also do the same things in Cubase. So that's how to use MIDI in Cubase, how to configure it and how to use it with your external synthesizers. Of course, the MIDI comes in from the keyboard to any internal synthesizer or any internal instrument, whatever they might be. Alrighty, now we have seen how Cubase is configured for MIDI instruments and controllers. I also briefly showed a way I have configured a MIDI remote within a Cubase, as you saw the monochrome module in there. Anyway, that concludes this session, and next we will go and see how the region is configured for MIDI, if at all. Remember to subscribe for the channel for more great content. Thanks for watching. Bye now.